Okay, assalamualaikum and a very good day to everyone who is watching this video. I'm Azhar Abdul Jalil, your PT for public speaking for Johor. Today I'm going to talk about how are you going to teach and guide your students for the public speaking competition for your district in preparation for the state level. Alright, now let's go to the next slide. Okay, the first thing you need to focus on is the title and the topic for your prepared speech. This is pivotal in any competition where the topic itself is going to speak volumes about what your student is going to deliver. Okay, first of all, don't reveal the content of the speech too much in the title. For example, benefits of reading. This is such a very cliche topic. So from the topic itself, the judges will know that, okay, this candidate is going to talk about the benefits. It's very cliche and there's no surprise to the judges. Okay, this is like what we want to try to avoid. Okay, and then we also need to choose a topic that has development of contact. If you just choose benefit of reading or advantages of sleeping early, you can read that anywhere and we can read it in the news or any videos on YouTube. But what make it special for us is the development of ideas, the layers of the ideas. How well is it going to be expanded in the speech? Okay, you have to add on some information from yourself too. That relates to your experience. And then try to avoid monotonous type of text, like I mentioned before. Something that is very monotonous, like benefits or advantages or my hobbies. Okay, these are all very cliche and we try to have a topic that can develop and show that your student is a very avid reader that knows his topic very well. Next, modify your text. Okay, I know in this IT world, we can get our text easily from the internet, from AI, ChatGPT, Copilot. Okay, but there are ways for us to get it, to check it online. You know that you have to submit your script early so that the judges are going to check it online and try, because the exact copy of the text is going to be penalized. Unless you try to rephrase some certain words, certain phrases, certain paragraph, okay, that will help you in trying to qualify your text as an original one, okay? Next, the mode of delivery, sorry. Okay, you need to mean what you say. Sometimes students, they express the content, they don't really express the content through effective body language. So it makes the whole presentation a little awkward. Okay, this is something that we need to avoid because it is going to affect your marks in the delivery marks. It is going to jeopardize, even though you have good content, the delivery marks is going to be jeopardized. It's going to be a little lower than you would expect. Okay, next, let's have a look at an example of a video.
And achievers are their response to failure. Failure is a part of your journey towards success because every single failure allows you to analyze your strategy and get better at it.
Okay, this candidate showed a very good body language that shows that he means what he said. Alright, he tried to emphasize the content so much. Okay, the body language shows. Okay, that's what you want to see. Okay, some candidates, when they talk about the content, they will be like, today I'm going to talk about this topic, the benefits of, okay, that is not very convincing. As you say, that's very mundane and very monotonous. Okay, see the body, your body language, your facial expression must show what you intend. Okay, next. Okay, prepared speech. Okay, actually for the accent here, it counts both ways for prepared and impromptu speech. Okay, if you are a natural, you have the accent, then go for it, okay? If you have it, you flaunt it, okay? But in some cases, we notice that some students try too hard to fake the accent, okay? It will cause you... You can see that it may affect the overall performance. The content is good, language is good, but the fake accent, it is really a no-no. Okay, try to avoid that if you are not confident with yourself. Okay, choose your words wisely because appropriate and accurate use of vocabs that can enhance the content and delivery is highly encouraged. Okay, as the video that I'll be showing you later on, okay, the student, the candidate, chose a language and vocabs, they are C1 level for CFR. Okay, try to train your student to use the C1 level of vocabulary so they can use it eloquently in their presentation. Next, you need to relate the topic with yourself. I know some students, they read books, they read a lot of facts. However, these are just merely facts. They don't state it, they don't relate it to themselves. Okay, this might be difficult because the judges want to see how you view the topic as your own, from your own point of view. Okay, this is what we want. We need your experience, point of view and your experience, and we need to know that, okay? Not just telling spitting facts, but without no relation to your experience. Okay, let's look at a video.
Words are, in my not so humble opinion, our most exhaustible source of magic, able of both inflicting the injury and remedying it. Those are the wise words of Albus Dumbledore, a professor from the Harry Potter series. And being so young and unintelligent, I didn't realize the heaviness of this phrase.
Okay, this candidate, she tried to quote Professor Albus Dumbledore from the Harry Potter series. Okay, the way she quoted it is quite out of the norm, you know, because when she tried to explain it, she didn't say that she quoted it as exactly, but the way she mentioned it, it's quite out of the norm, and we can say that the words choice that she used was very efficient in delivering what her thought was. And then by the end of the video, actually she mentioned about how it related to herself and how she was bullied because of her imperfections. Okay, this is something that you need to relate on because you can see the excellent choice of words and bringing yourself into the speech. Okay, all the boxes are tick. Okay, this is what we want. Okay, next. Okay, topics. Okay, one of the topics for impromptu speech. Okay, for your topic, you need to try to think out of the box. Try to be creative when you are talking about a topic because under pressure, in those 4 minutes of preparation, you need to allocate the time to speak for 3 minutes and the ideas need to be well pointed out. Okay, I know this is going to be a lot of pressure for the candidate. However, an excellent speaker, they can organize their thoughts very well. They don't really need to jot down their thoughts because it's already up here. They have mentally trained, okay? And some people, they talk about the same idea. For example, there was this once, the topic was for impromptu speech, the topic was green. All of the students talk about greenery, saving the environment, but there's this one candidate who think out of the box because they use the word green from the idiom green with envy. Okay, so the whole topic, this candidate stood out because the topic was different and the way of delivery was really different and effective to the judges. So this stands out more and the candidate got a high chance to represent the district at that time. Okay, plus, don't be too serious when you are talking. Okay, relax, chill. You need to be professional, but at the same time, friendly. Okay, those are the key points of delivery. Next, choose your words. Okay, here for impromptu speech, the marks allocation is a little different from prepared speech. You can see here, you are going to be allocated 30 marks for the delivery from the overall score, okay? So you need to focus on your selection of words carefully. You are using C1 vocabulary that could enhance your delivery. Okay. Next, you need to plan your speech because sometimes students, they can speak very well, but by the end of the second bell, which is on the third minute, okay, the candidate still cannot finish the speech. And the climax of the speech itself hasn't been pointed out. Okay, so the student had to be had to finish the speech abruptly. This caused a lot of marks, okay? Because it's a PT. The language is very well done, very well delivered. However, the content, not so much. So you need to have this, deliver this content in that fixed amount of time, okay? Where's the climax is going to be, how it's going to subside in the conclusion. Because the conclusion itself is going to be the main point. Sorry, not the really main point. It's going to be something that will last in the judge's mind. Because what you said before, they might forget, but the conclusion will make a long last. Sorry, long last impact to the judges. Okay, let's see. Elements of surprise and climax can also help your presentation more effective. Okay, like I mentioned before. Okay, and there need to be one thing that need to be mentioned here. Both prepared and impromptu speech are just as important because the marks will be combined by the end of the competition to determine the winner. All right, let's have a look at our last video.
And beauty is in the eye of the beholder. Help me to become a much more confident person. And I was able to face that friend of mine who has said mean things about me confidently. So remember, that was the beginning of wisdom for me. It was the pivoting point of my life when I watched that scene from Harry Potter. So you need to know that being wise in words equals to the beginning of wisdom to so many people. Thank you.
As you can see here, the candidate ended her speech with a very well-concluded phrase and sentence. This can conclude everything that she has mentioned. She also added some see-on-one words like pivotal, okay, which can enhance what the ideas that she is trying to share. Okay, this is what we try to find in our candidates. If you have this kind of candidate in your school, please train them as well as you can for the betterment of Johor. Okay, I think that's all for today from me. Assalamualaikum and a very good day.